In this video, we're going to be looking at how to set up a radio menu in a couple different applications. We're going to go from start to finish and walk you through some of the new settings that are inside the radio menu and the mini editor inside of Tablet Pro Studio. So the purpose of the radio menu, this allows you to do a handful of different things. Let's draw here first. A handful of different things that would be very difficult without a keyboard. So here we're smoothing, we're using the shift key, the alt key, the control key, and then we're going to resize the brush. And we're going to undo. So those things are quite difficult. Let's also look at panning the screen or panning the object on the screen. This is alt plus shift. So I'm going to talk about how to set that up and show you where to get some of these pre-made radio presets for your use. You don't have to do all of this work, just a little bit of tweaking. Okay, so the secret to opening up the radio menu editing, you're going to press the front or the back button. This is the invert button. This is the barrel button. You're going to press and hold it and then tap on the radio menu. Now we're in editing mode, and what we can do is we can select one of these items down here. You can see the tooltip for it, and this will allow us to change what it does. So you can see here on this one, which is our panning tool, shift and alt are set. It's set to single use and blank. Now for a lot of these, what you can do, let's see, control Z, this is set to hotkey. Control is selected right here. Z is selected from this drop down, and we have this set to a specific mode here. Now there's five different modes currently. We may be adding another mode to help with support of iPad usage for radio menu, but I'm not sure yet. So here, do not hold. This is going to send it one time, just like you tapped the keyboard just once. Single use means it's going to hold it down until you stop using the stylus or you pull the stylus away from the screen. Hold sticky toggle. This is going to hold it down until you trigger it again. This does not always work. So some situations this does not function. So if that's the case, then you can't use it. Sorry. Panel toggle. This will send the hotkey once. So if you have a panel that you want to open up with F7, like a layers panel inside of Photoshop, then you do panel toggle. It'll open the panel. You can tap the stylus one time, and so it would be like switching in between layers or changing one option, picking a color from a color set or something like that. And then after you use the stylus once, it will send the hotkey again, closing the panel. And keystroke repeater, this one works by dragging the stylus back and forth on the screen. And so every time you move, a certain distance on the screen, you'll hear a clicking sound, and it will mean that Control Z or whatever that hotkey is being sent again. So if you want to undo 50 times, then instead of constantly opening and closing the radio menu, you can just, let's take a look at it. All right, so let's change the size here. Let's do a handful. All right, and we're going to undo. And there we go. So pretty neat feature, something that I appreciate personally. All right, so this is how these are set up. We can go through these single use. Again, this is going to allow us for something where you need to hold it down. This is going to allow you to hold that key down until you're done using it. So if you're doing a hover movement, like resize, where you have to hover the stylus and drag left or right in order to get something to change, this is a good way to do it, single use. Tab, just do not hold. Space, do not hold. Some of these you have to play around with and figure out what works best in your situation. Notice here, there are little circles, or little arrows right here, here, here. This is showing you the placement of this button on the radio menu. These ones are pointing in, these ones are pointing out. This is the inside four, the inside four, you can see this is the bottom, this is the right. And you can see this is the corner, and it shows that up here. Now, if you want to swap the position of something here, if reorganize tiles right here is checked, then when you tap here and you tap, oh, we're going to do this one. We're going to tap it a second time, click on another Docker tile to swap this tile with. We're going to click here. Now we have the update to radio menu. Any changes that you make in the radio menu, in order to get those to populate, to show up in the radio menu, you need to click on update to radio menu. You can click anywhere over here. All right, so you can see that our zooming tool, Control plus Alt, has moved with our smoothing, our shift tool, or our shift keyboard section. Now, the radio menu used to have just 12 operations. That's what you see right here. We now have the option for a second radio menu. Now I'm using the second side button on the stylus to trigger this. So we're going to open to edit. You'll notice that now you have the option of using button names that are letters. And you can do up to 3 letters, simply because more doesn't fit and doesn't look good. You can change your tooltips right here. If you want to show the tooltips, radio menu, show tooltips, apply. Here you can see what those are. This does sometimes get in the way of clicking them. So if you happen to bring your tooltip, or the tooltip shows up on top, if you click the tooltip, it won't activate the same way. Sometimes you have a blank icon. That means that the icon that was used is not supported, and so you need to change that to something different. Now, in order to change an icon, we're going to select this. We're going to go to the Appearance tab, and you can click anywhere up here, and it'll toggle back and forth between the two. Now, in the Appearance tab, this one is Control-Z. We're going to search for the actual one that we use is Reply. And then you can click right here on this radio icon here. This does the same thing as this little one right here, which is update to radio menu. So here you can see that we now have an icon here where we didn't have one before. All right, let's look again over here at the appearance tab, adding a tooltip. You can add that here and use this to undo. And that'll show the tooltip or add the tooltip to it. Now here, let's say that I want to change the color to white. All right, great. We have it white now. Let's say we want to make this blue one. We want that blue one to be white. We're going to copy this color by clicking on copy. We're going to use this arrow right here and this one right here to move back and forth between the Docker items. Notice that we can see now this icon, the color is blue. We're going to paste the color and update. Now these are both white, and you can do this very quickly in between the different icons on the Docker. Right here, this will switch between stack buttons. Stack buttons don't work on the radio menu. These are just for the artist pad. Now, in order to trigger the radio menus in whatever preset you're in, which is right over here, say on Blender, we want this to trigger radio menu A with the barrel button and invert radio menu B. You just select that here from the dropdown. To customize it, you can click here. That will bring up the exact same menu as holding the side button and clicking on the radio menu. Now, if you're setting a click location here, this will create a true coordinate. And what that means is that it will adjust for whether the artist pad is showing, whether the voice access is showing at the top, and it will adjust it. So whether those are showing or not, it'll click the same position that you set. as if there was nothing else on the screen, and then it will modify that position based off of anything else that's open from Tablet Pro or like the Windows Accessibility Voice Access feature. So this is great. And if you're using a different mode on the screen, so you are rotating it and instead of using a landscape mode, you're using a portrait mode, this will change the radial menu to one specific for portrait mode, one specific for landscape mode or inverted landscape or inverted portrait mode, so that if you're clicking locations on the screen or you have a different setup in those spots, it will remember how you change it and save it as a new radial preset. And this is really important for programs like OneNote and other ones. All right, so let's go ahead and create a radial menu for OneNote. If you're here inside of OneNote, you select radial menu A or B, it will look very similar to this. These icons I will probably change to white. So what we're going to do is we're going to start with this, which is what you'll start with, and we'll change it. All right, so we're here in OneNote. I'm going to grab this one. We're going to paste it on the screen so we have something to try to emulate. All right, so we're going to hold the side button, click, and then what I'm going to do, notice up here it says additional operations, add to radio menu. I'm going to choose, instead of pick button, I'm going to choose continuous. And enter. All right, now we're going to hover over cancel. We're going to update to radio menu. Now you can see that we've got a radio menu that's mostly done. Once you've added those to the radio menu, click on Update to Radio Menu in order to see those. And then you can just select these and modify these the way that you would like. So we have Undo. You can use any icon that you would like here. Copy. Now we have that radio menu set up. We can make any modifications that we want to it. Let's look at the settings for radio menu. Here we have mouse and pen position. This is going to try to align the radio menu to your pen tip all the time. This doesn't always work because sometimes we're sending click locations to a certain spot on the screen, and then we're hovering and clicking here, and that doesn't update the way that we would like it to. So we try our best to put it underneath the pen tip. You have the option of centering it to the screen or a user-defined location. If you use that, then you would set that location right here. You have the option of showing tooltips, keeping the radio menu opened after clicking on an icon.